Yeah, and I did want to just kind of go into one more aspect of the history of the Iraq War. And I don't want this to detract from, I mean, it was Iraqis who suffered by far worse than any American did and still do today. I mean, their entire lives are defined by this horrible thing that's happened to them. But of course, so many soldiers and families had their lives thrown into chaos. Of course, you know, close to 5,000 died, tens of thousands of amputees, hundreds of thousands with post-traumatic stress disorder and traumatic brain injury. But one of the other aspects that just proves why we can't trust the politicians and the Pentagon brass when they're sending us to war is how they treated us when we got home. And there's, I want to tell the story of a soldier named Derek Kirkland. I ended up getting to know his mother very well and soldiers that served with him. He had a kind of gruesome experience in Iraq. And I tell this story only to help people who weren't there understand what the Iraq War really was like. Derek Kirkland was a young infantryman. They had raided a house and they shot one of the guys in the house in the chest, right? And the guy was still alive. So Kirkland's platoon sergeant ordered him to stand on the guy's chest. Stand, put it so the guy would bleed out faster and die faster. So Kirkland does this horrible thing, didn't want to do it. Not too long after, he tries to kill himself in Iraq, right? So he's got a shotgun in his mouth. Someone catches him. They send him home, right? Because he's suicidal, right? On his layover flight in Germany, he tries to kill himself a second time and fails, right? He tries to OD on pills, but it doesn't work out. So then he gets back to his unit at Fort Lewis. He tries to kill himself a third time by cutting his wrists open. So he shows up to formation completely gashed and bloody. And so his platoon sergeant made fun of him in front of the unit, calling him a pussy, like all of these things, for being weak and trying. So three suicide attempts. He goes to mental health. The mental health doctor, an officer, rates him a low risk for suicide. So three suicide attempts in 2 weeks and got rated a low risk for suicide. And then he hung himself in his wall locker in his barracks room and successfully killed himself on that fourth attempt. That is just one small microcosm of what happened throughout the entire army, the epidemic of suicides, where one soldier a day was committing suicide. There was like something like 400 suicide attempts a month in the active duty military. And this went on for years, and the military didn't give a shit. The officers did not care. The politicians did not care. Not only that, not only did they do nothing to try to help the people who were saying they needed help, but they punished people. They had punished Kirkland. They punished people for attempting suicide. And then they actively denied people PTSD diagnosis. They said, no, you don't have PTSD. You have a pre-existing condition, a personality disorder, just so they could deploy them again and again and again back to Iraq and back to Afghanistan. And so if it doesn't convince you the horrible things that the U.S. let happen to the Iraqi people, if that doesn't convince you that this government doesn't give a shit about us and is only in it for some rich men and for Wall Street, the way they treated the people that they had sent to do the killing for them, that should be all the only other thing you need to convince you that we can't trust these people and we shouldn't follow their orders.